are you looking for interview question for front-end machine coding round? So there are so many things available on the internet in articles, videos, and lot more, right? It's very confusing what to basically focus in and what all, because there is no limit to it, right? There are so many things around the world, like we can't actually end up working or developing everything before actually appearing into any of the machine coding round, right? So this video is basically going to help you. What are the things basically, what are the machine coding problem statement you should focus before actually appearing into the any of the front end interviews? And trust me, if you go through the 11 problem statement that I'm going to talk about, you will be able to crack most of the machine coding round. And obviously the way you code and the techniques and the things are definitely going to help you. If you haven't watched my previous video, which talks about the techniques in order to crack the machine coding round, I will suggest you please go and watch that. This is going to be very important for you. Okay, with this, I welcome you to Check the System Design series. I am Chirag Goyal, and we will be covering the most important interviews questions for machine coding round. And if you are looking to crack any of your dream companies, it can be a fan company like Facebook, Microsoft, Google, Amazon, Netflix. It can be any of the unicorn if you can talk about, right? It can be like Flipkart, Dream 11, Uber, or any of the other, like nowadays there are so many, Razorpay, Meesho, right? Byju's, Cred, Coin DSX, right? So Coinbase, Pharmacy, these are very popular, you can say, Indian startups, and people are looking to chase and crack these companies. If you are the one who wanted to crack any of these interviews, any of the machine coding around in these companies, watch this video till the end, and definitely all the 11 problem statement which we are going to discuss are going to help you to crack your machine coding round. So keep watching till the end. Let's talk about most popular front-end interviews question. There are so many like questions as we talked about, and we are going to cover the 11 of them. In most of them, I'm going to also talk about like how a same problem statement can be given to a UI1 and UI3 basically, as you can say, a entry level and a senior front-end engineer, and how the questions can be deviated or the expectation can be different from different people, right? So let's quickly dive through that. So the first one, the Google like type ahead. So when we say Google like type ahead, you start typing something, you get some suggestion, and there are certain things. There can be certain icon, there can be icon on the right hand side, there can be functionality where you submit. Like it can, this question can differ from Google auto suggest to, you can say, Flipkart auto suggest to the, you can say, it can be BigBasket, it can be any sort of thing, right? So you have, you when you start typing, you get the certain list, and these lists can be provided you as an API response, or someone can ask you to hard code this altogether, right? So problem statement can vary from a normal to, you can consider where you have to write a debounce, or you have to also think about the about controller. A lot of things comes into the picture, and you have to also think about this is a popover that will come, right, from the design ethics. So are you thinking about making it generic so that most of the places you can use the same component altogether? Are you even thinking about where to keep the API call and who will make an API call? Or are you thinking about the data which you are seeing over here can be generic enough where the consumer makes a takes a call how you wanted to basically represent this data, right? And there can be certain more things where you are asked to basically do a filter on the client side, where you have a static data and you have to do a filter and you have to show this data. So this problem statement can vary from like UI 1, 2, 3 based on the multiple parameters, the questions that we have talked about. This is the first. What's the second one, which is again very popular, is the implement Google like day calendar. It seems like very simple. You can have certain grids, you can iterate from, you can say 24 hours, and you can showcase that. But the important challenging thing in this problem statement is your data. How well you are modeling your data is very important, because you have to think about, you have to showcase those meetings, right? And those meetings can be multiple hours, multiple days. Within an hour, there can be multiple meetings. There can be overlapping meeting, right? There can be a short meeting, and there can be lot adjacent meeting. In the same time, you have multiple meetings. So many things comes to the complexity, and this is what basically a person wanted to see, how you are able to represent, how you are able to design those things, and how you are thinking in terms of the data basically for this Google like day calendar, right? This is another very popular problem statement. Third problem statement is regarding your Microsoft Excel like spreadsheet, or you can say the Google sheet spreadsheet sort of thing. Over here, the complexity is people can ask you to design this grid. This designing this grid is okay, but complexity rises when you have drag and drop. Complexity rises when you actually can write a formula in any of the cell, and those formula you can modify, and basically that does something based on the multiple column or multiple rows, like how you are going to manage that. So those are the things which are going to actually make a kick and make a difference altogether. So try to focus on those things. And again, here the data is also going to be very important and challenging, along with the performance which a person wanted to see with this problem statement as in given, how you are having your event delegation sort of thing, how you are managing your data, how your updates are going to happen, how what all will re-render basically when you make a small change in any of these cell, right? Those things are going to be matter a lot when you actually design this problem statement. The fourth problem statement, which is very popular, is rendering your form dynamically. When we say rendering your form dynamically, it's more about you are given a configuration which says that it has multiple fields, and like it has first name, last name, it has a street address, address has a street, city, state, or pin code. It can be any kind of JSON or the structure that is given. That is a configuration that will be given, and you are supposed to actually render the full form. What it meant by your individual field can be of different type. It can be radio button, it can be text area, it can be normal input box, right? It can be select. So you have to basically go through that particular type and the model which is given. Based on that, you will be implementing those things independently, and basically you are going to render all those you can say form field based on the types which are given. Problem statement doesn't ends over here. Depending on what sort of level you are, this problem statement can vary, where you are also asked to write the validations for this, right? This is going to be a very different level altogether. When we say validation, so consider someone wants a minimum length of like 5 character for the first name, or your pin code should match to a list of the zip code which is provided to you, right? So those kind of the things which are become challenging basically when you have the configuration driven. So those are the next level which you can think and you can basically propose while you are in an interview. So this is again very very popular, and most of the companies do ask it.
This is
Implement progress bar. So this seems to be a very simple problem statement where you can use multiple approaches. You can use CSS animation, you can JavaScript request frame, right? Animation frame. So there can be other things like you can use set timeout, set interval sort of thing in order to achieve it, right? So many things. It looks very simple. But again, this complexity can increase when we say only the second, you can say progress bar will start once the first is completed, right? And again, you can add n number of them and it can go to the n number of waiting queue. It can be like your color coding of this progress bar will change if it has completed certain parameters or certain percentage, right? So similarly, these complexity can change, and there can be complex scenario where in the single progress bar shows the different color, like as a different gradient, and depending on what sort of percentage you have completed, or you have capability to click on these in order to like divide and distribute certain things. So this is again very popular, and this complexity can keep on changing depending on what sort of role you are appearing for. Implement a star rating widget. It seems to be very very simple problem statement. But again, this problem statement actually becomes critical when you have to actually showcase. There are two part of it. One, you can actually give a rating, which is very simple. You click on any of the 1, 2, 3, any of the star, those number of rating are given. Second is you want to showcase like the average of that, and average can be basically like it can be partial, like 4.7. How to showcase that in your normal stars basically, or the icons that we use, you don't have the capability to showcase the partial different color. How you are going to basically do that and achieve that? So those are the important thing. Focus on that. Try to implement Twitter post like text area. This is again it looks like very simple. You have to add a text area and your job is done. But no. So think about if you have to add certain capabilities where when you type at the rate, you have to show the suggestions where you can tag people. You can actually add a link. You can add, say, suppose multiple things like images, video, and different kind of thing. You can add over here. You can add emoji. There can be capability where you wanted to show how much characters are left in order to tweet this, right? In Twitter, you might have seen. So showing that progress and showing the number of characters it has spilled over, right? So considering the special character which you may or may not have to count. So those are the important things which makes this more complex, and try it out and actually explore it out, and this is going to help you. Either that is text area or that is div, basically which has capability to like edit the content. So this is going to be a great fun. To do, this is one which we start with everyone, every developer, every front-end developer, starting with any of the, you can say framework, they start to implement a to-do application, right? It seems to be very simple and people think like, oh, I'm champ in that. But again, it comes with a lot of complexity when you can have certain lot of filter, like either it is active completed, either if it is marked completed, you can actually strike it and you get a capability to delete it altogether. So again, so there are so many things which you have to do handling on the enter and navigation sort of thing in order to make it more intuitive. So and obviously you have to think about your rendering performance. What if you have to, once it is completed, you have to move to a different section altogether, how you are going to handle it with a more performant way. Think on those direction. Design card page. This is again, this seems to be very, very, very simple, and but it comes with lot complexity, right? So this is one of the famous, I think, in the Flipkart also, in multiple companies, this is one of the famous where you have to design your cart altogether. When we say cart, sometimes you are given an API, sometimes you are asked to design your own data model. Now certain things are, parameters are given, you have to focus on that. What is the maximum quantity? What are the different sizes which are available? The prices, the coupons that can be applied, right? And when you apply those things, you have to do a like computation on the local, and on top of it, you have to show the total cart value, the discounts which are going to be applied, where certain discounts are going to be applied on certain products only. So thinking about those things and finally like having a final algorithm which computes this. So most of the time, if you write your algorithm or your utility at a separate place altogether, which you consume afterward, that makes your life very easy, right? And most of the people mess up it because they start directly jumping into the code. So which I have already talked about in the previous video, do check out. And yeah, next, and comes with a lot of complexity, and people are aware, because one is the listing, second is definitely it can be pagination, there can be shorting algorithm that can be written, and there can be some filtering that can be done. And what if all of these are asked on the UI to be implemented, right? Or someone asked you to basically, okay, you can make a network call, now define what are the APIs, how you are going to make a request and response, what is the response expected from the backend, and how you are, what are the critical information that you are going to post inside the API request, right? So these are the things that can be expected. And obviously the look and feel, there can be some CSS animation when you hover on that, you get some scaling effect and lot more effect which you can get. So just get your hand dirty and see how these things are done, especially the pagination, which is a very important and popular thing. 11th, which is again very, very popular and cool, which is asked in most of the interviews, which is build your tic-tac-toe. It seems to be very simple because again, if you have to think about the game, tic-tac-toe is one of the famous game which most of the people have worked upon. But this complexity keep on changing. If I say you have to develop n by n tic-tac-toe, and again, if I say you have to tell about the who is the winner at a complexity of O of 1, right? Now the challenges start, like how you are going to store your data, how you will make sure your things does not re-render multiple times. So those kind of challenges will come into the picture and you have to think about. So try it out. Most important, you may not have to actually implement all these 11 things, but the functionality and the feature and the complexity that those are involved in these 11 problem statement, if you are well versed with that, trust me, you are going to crack any of the machine coding round. It will be combination of any of these feature, complexity, or the capabilities that we have discussed, and you will be easily able to use your knowledge and like rock the machine coding round. And if you wanted to contribute, if you wanted to share your knowledge or something, the code which you have written in for any of these things, do add in the comment. I will be happy to look into that, and maybe we can come and you can come on the channel altogether, where you can actually do a mock interview for any of these problem statement. Yeah, we have covered 11 very popular front-end machine coding round interviews question, right? So apart from just these 11 problem statement, the functionality which are covered in these 11 are generic, and basically mostly the interviews questions are asked around that. So go and practice on those 11 problem statement, and especially the features which are given. And in case you wanted to share your experiences and the code, do comment and share the link. I will be happy to review that. And if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe and share with your buddies. So keep watching Chuck the System Design. See you in the next video.